8 of the weirdest tourist attractions in Florida. Florida already has a reputation of being somewhat of a lawless, wild state. Known for the many crazy crimes of its Florida men, its abundant alligators, and residents who just don't fear hurricanes, Florida is often jokingly called the worst state in the country. So it's no wonder that most of the tourists that do visit the state are there for its large selection of theme parks, including Walt Disney World. After all, if you're gonna visit a place known for its chaos, you might as well visit the few areas that you know are safe and happy, right? But if you're looking for something less conventional to do on your day off from Disney and Universal, there are plenty of locations throughout the Sunshine State that will help it live up to its reputation. Whether it's strange structures, people tracking mythical creatures, or an island held captive by animals, Florida has something to see for every type of tourist. Before we get started, make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Now, here are 8 of the weirdest tourist attractions in Florida. Number 8, Gatorland. The first entry on our list is a theme park. And while you won't find Mickey Mouse or Donald Duck roaming the grounds, you will see a lot of animals. Gatorland, located on an orange blossom trail in Orlando, calls itself the alligator capital of the world. Surprisingly, the theme park has actually been around longer than Disney. It was founded in 1949 by Owen Godwin and has expanded into a 110-acre theme park. At Gatorland, visitors can see a variety of animals, including snakes, birds, and of course, alligators. The park has over 2,000 alligators that call it home, ranging from tiny hatchlings to extremely old and rare albino gators. Visitors are able to touch, hold, and even feed the gators with a bizarre contraption that looks like a fishing rod filled with hot dogs. If the park sounds kind of corny, that's because it is. But the Gatorland team have created the massive park for another reason: to allow it to double as a massive nature reserve. Through the profits of the park, they teamed up to create the Florida Wildlife Institute. Today, Gatorland is considered the leading source of alligator education and safety. Talk about a weird way to achieve a noble cause. Number 7, Coral Castle. If the idea of holding an animal that might snap your arm in one bite is too much for you, you might enjoy the more laid-back Coral Castle. At first glance, Coral Castle may not seem that impressive. It's simply a large structure built out of massive chunks of limestone and coral. However, the legends that surround it are what make it interesting. Supposedly, the structure was built single-handedly by its founder, Edward Lidskalin. The stories claim that Edward was rejected by his long-term fiancé while living in Latvia. To deal with his grief, Ed moved to the US and began to construct the Coral Castle over the course of 28 years in Miami-Dade County, Florida. Ed claimed to have built the entire structure with no advanced tools, supposedly moving the stone blocks, which weighed several tons each, by himself. Before his death in 1951, Ed would not reveal the method he used to build the castle, leaving some to speculate that he used magnetic fields or even supernatural powers to build it. The castle includes numerous structures, including an 8-ton stone that acts as a gate, so finely crafted that it could easily be rotated with the push of a single hand. Though it's tempting to believe the stories about Ed's secret building insight, scholars claim that the structure was built by craftily using leverage and pulleys, much like the ancient pyramids. Number 6, Casadega. Have you ever been driving down a road when you saw a small shack that offered psychic readings for a small price? Have you ever wished you could go to a place where those shacks are everywhere? Well, if you ever have the chance to visit Casadega, Florida, your dream may just come true. Located just north of Deltona, Casadega is a small town that is said to be inhabited almost exclusively by psychics and mediums. The town was founded in 1875 by George Colby, a psychic who said the town came to him in a vision while at a seance. The town was a hit, and today it's inhabited by about 55 families who all claim to have psychic powers and offer their services to the public. Everything from seances to tarot card readings to healing ceremonies can be found in this town. However, make sure you don't visit on a Sunday, the only day that the town does not offer their services. If you don't want to know your future, there are other activities available, including nighttime photo tours that allow you to capture mysterious orbs of energy on film. Number 5, Solomon's Castle. The second castle to make it on the list, Solomon's Castle is a sprawling 12,000 square foot structure in Ona, Florida. Howard Solomon, a sculptor, decided to build the castle as a makeshift museum for his own art. In other words, the castle was meant to be a display case for the pieces of his art that didn't sell. Solomon began to construct the castle in 1972 and continued to tweak the structure until his death in 2016. It's giant, a full 3 stories and covered from top to bottom with highly reflective aluminum panels. It features several spires, a full wraparound balcony, and a wrought iron retractable gate that serves as the entrance. The attraction also features a working restaurant housed inside a 60-foot-long, accurate reconstruction of a Portuguese galleon. Though Solomon passed away in 2016, his family proudly continues his legacy. 4 generations of Solomons have lived in the castle and have decided to continue running the attraction to keep it open to visitors. And if you're looking for an inexpensive trip while in Florida, admission to the castle is less than $13 per adult. I guess Howard knew the value of a good bargain. Number 4. Neptune Memorial Reef. Though the Spanish explorer Ponce de Leon once believed that the Fountain of Youth was in St. Augustine, no one has ever pegged Florida as the location of Atlantis, the lost underwater city. However, off the coast of Key Biscayne in Miami, there was a sunken city that was once known as the Atlantis Memorial Reef. If you were to swim about 3 miles from the coast and then dove 40 feet down, you would discover the 16-acre city, which was constructed in 2007 by the Neptune Company. The area is meant to be a memorial for the dead. Neptune is a cremation company, and for a fee, they allow customers to have their loved ones' ashes mixed into concrete, cast into a form, and placed in the underwater city. Customers can then scuba dive down to the city and visit their loved ones in their eternal resting place. The city boasts a variety of decor, including ancient-looking columns, large lion statues, and even a special place in honor of the remains of Bert Kilbride, the record holder for the oldest scuba diver. If you're a fan of nautical adventures, this is a great stop. Or, if you're particularly enchanted, a place to stay forever. Number 3. Aerojet Dade Rocket Facility. Movies will have you believe that the government is fiercely protective about any technology they develop or test, and that the only way to see some is to sneak into a top-secret facility at your own risk. However, Aerojet Rocket Facility begs to differ. Located outside of Homestead, Florida, 2 rocket silos sit in the middle of a whopping 25,000 acres of land. If you're able to find the silos, you're in for a treat. Inside, most of the structure is intact, and the previous tenants have left something behind. An actual rocket. The site was once home to Aerojet testing, as the company attempted to test the efficiency of solid rocket fuel in hopes of securing a contract with NASA. Unfortunately for the company, NASA soon decided to start using liquid jet fuel, and Aerojet lost investors and funding, causing the facility to be vacated and closed. Despite attempts to prevent urban explorers from accessing the site by installing large concrete beams, it's still relatively easy to access the silo and take a look at the facility's final SL-3 rocket, which sits, still covered in its steel plating. There's an easy joke in here about getting to see something out of this world, but I won't say it because that's too cheesy. Wait. Number 2. Monkey Island. Have you ever wondered what happens to monkeys that start disrupting the zoos they were supposed to inhabit? Probably not, but the answer is that some of them get sent to Monkey Island. Monkey Island started as an uninhabited island in the middle of a stream in Homosassa, Florida. Just a few miles down the stream, a land developer was working on a wildlife exhibition that is now Homosassa Wildlife State Park. The developer had a small batch of monkeys shipped to Homosassa in hopes of using them as an exhibit in the park. However, he quickly discovered that the monkeys were extremely mischievous and skilled escape artists. Unable to contain them within the park, the developer banished 5 monkeys to live on the small island. Dubbed Monkey Island, the spot quickly became a tourist favorite. Fruit trees were planted to provide the critters with food, and huts were built for shelter. 40 years later, some of the original monkeys still survive, and have even added some new babies to their clan. And at number 1, we have the Skunk H Research Quarters. If you've never heard of the skunk ape, you're not alone. This elusive creature is supposedly native to the Florida Everglades, and is essentially Florida's very own Bigfoot. Or at least, that's according to Dave Sheely. Once described as the Jane Goodall of the Everglades, Sheely has made his entire living off attempting to track down the skunk ape, a 7-foot-tall bipedal ape with reddish-brown fur and a horrible stench. Though the skunk ape is not recognized by any official wildlife institutes, that has not deterred Sheely from actively seeking out the creature. Dave is so determined, in fact, that he created the Skunk Ape Research Headquarters in Ochepee, Florida. The headquarters is actually the converted main office of the Trails Lake Campground, a camping site owned by Dave's brother. There, the 2-cell memorabilia, supplies, and even a field guide filled with tips on how best to search for the elusive creature. Worried about finding one? Dave insists it's possible if you follow his steps, claiming to have seen the creature 3 times over the course of his life. If you're not in the mood for a wilderness adventure but still want to participate in some good old-fashioned skunk ape fun, The campground throws a Miss Skunk Ape pageant in June and Skunktoberfest in October. Attendees say the events are really fun, though we can't promise how they smell. So, have you visited any of the attractions on the list? Are you a Florida native? Let me know in the comment section, and before you leave, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.